Okay, so for the final term, we begin with a new chapter, Mother Bear's Call. It is written by Harriet Prescott Spofford. Now, this is a lovely story for the children, where the children from the forest have brought a bear cub, and as they enter the family, see the reaction of the family and what happens in search of the bear cub. The bear, mother bear, also comes and she creates a scene, and finally the cub is gone with the mother. So let's go through this story. Maria from an upper window spied the children coming, tugging the basket along. She called down to old uncle and Aunt Susan on the piazza. Now Maria was a person who was looking up from the window above. She was secretly looking at what the children have brought in the basket, which they were carrying from the far distance, and they were tugging it very closely to itself, to themselves. So she called down for old uncle and Aunt Suzanne to gather near the piazza, that means near the veranda. If them children are not bringing home a cub, so she was worried whether these children are bringing the cub along with them. What is there in their basket? Old uncle stirred in his hammock. Aunt Susan went down the steps. Now, old uncle, who was lying on a hammock. Hammock is a kind of a swing. If you see this picture here, you will see that old uncle is lying on a hammock. This is a hammock, a swing. Okay. So, he twisted and turned and came out of the hammock. And so was Aunt Susan. She also stepped down and she came near where the children were approaching. What will they do next? Said old uncle, as the twins came up with the joyful outcry. Now, uncle, with utmost curiosity, he wanted to know what these children are going to do next. As the twins came up with a joyful outcry, that means the twins, both the kids were of the same age of and were born on the same day. So they both came with a very joyful note. And they wanted to exhibit the treasure. Treasure, why is it treasure? It is very expensive, very precious for these two children, that bear cub. And that is why they consider it a treasure. He rose and peered into the basket. So, old uncle, he got up and he peeped inside the basket. We thought you would be pleased, Easy faltered. So now, EC, one of the twins, she says, oh, we thought you'll be so pleased seeing all this, aren't you? So she's asking. She spoke in a way that shows that she was not very confident of the looks, the way uncle had showed. Why, uncle? Cried Allie. Why, old uncle? Don't you love a baby bear? Now, since they were not sure through the looks of uncle, so they were trying to confirm that, are you not happy seeing this baby bear? I just want you to see him suck my fingers. You can't help loving him. So the two kids said, ki see, you would be so happy to see the baby cub. It's so lovingly licking up my finger. I love you, teased old uncle, catching her up to a place in the hammock beside himself. But you can't help him alive on your fingers, even if he only sucked one a day. So now uncle said, ki, okay, you are saying that it's nice to see the baby sucking your finger, but then this old little baby, it cannot survive on sucking the finger. It will die, because just sucking the finger won't make him feel better. He'll still be hungry. The baby cub would still be hungry, even if it sucked up your finger each day. You are just funning, said Allie. Pinch your nose. How to feed him, and so does Michael. I reckon EC and I could too. So now Ali is saying, ki, uncle, don't bother, don't worry. Pincher knows how to feed this baby cub, and so does Michael. So they wanted that they would ask either Pincher or Michael for help, and gradually EC and Ali can also learn the way how to feed the baby cub. Old uncle, we won't let him be a bit of trouble, said EC. So now Isi confirmed, dear uncle, don't feel worried. We will make sure that this little cub doesn't bother anyone. So now to this, of course, he won't be any trouble, said Aunt Susan. She and Aunt Rose had brought a bottle of warm milk with a rag over the top of it. So now, not only just Aunt Susan was ready to help, so was another aunt in the house, Aunt Rose. They both agreed that they would feed the baby cub, and they had brought warm milk along with them, and it was covered with a rag, that means a thick cloth on top of it. They put it into the little bear's mouth, and the whole family gathered around to see him take his dinner. So now they gave the bottle for feeding to this old this bear cub, and they also gathered around next to the cub to see how it was doing. Okay, now his grunts of satisfaction were very funny. At last the little fellow let go the bottle, stretched himself and rolled over on the grass. Now once the cub finished its milk bottle and was quite satisfied, now it was happy. It stretched its hands and legs and body parts and was rolling over in satisfaction, making out noises. Grunts are the short noises made by the animal. So, and those were of satisfaction. That means he was quite satisfied. His tummy was full, so he was happy. And this was making them feel very funny. That grunting noise was very funny, which he was making. Okay, and he rolled over the grass and looked so good natured, you would almost have said he was laughing. And it appeared as if he was so happy and satisfied that it was appearing as if he was laughing. And Aunt Susan said, a little bear is a little deer. So now Aunt Susan was equally pleased seeing this baby bear, the cub, and she says, oh, this little bear is so cute, so dear, it's so nice. The cub must have been pretty tired with all the attention and endearments he received that day, not to say anything about Master Will's efforts to make him stand on his hind legs when he tumbled over every time like a mold of jelly. So now the cub was almost very tired because of the attention the whole family was giving him, and also the endearments, that means all the lavish things which were words of affections and action which was done to him, all had made him get very tired because the whole day it was in front of the family and was a big show to them. So finally, and not to top it all, that Master Will, there was another person called Will, and he was making an effort to hold the bear through his front legs and make him stand on his hind legs, that is the back legs. And the number of time he used to make the cub stand on its hind leg, it used to roll down. Why? Because the legs were weak right now. It was just a baby. So it appeared as if it's a jelly mold. You must have seen a jelly. Your mama must have cooked for you. So those jellies, just as they shake and have no basic figure of their own, they take the size of the utensil. In the same way, the baby bear used to curl around and roll down. Once it was every time Master Will used to hold him and make him stand on his hind legs. But at last, and after his supper, he was put to sleep in the shed on a little truss of hay under an old blanket, where as soon as he was alone, he began to whimper for his mother. But the children did not hear him. They had trooped upstairs to their own beds, all of them as tired as the cub himself, and were presently sound asleep. So now, after giving the supper, now all had moved off from them, from the baby cub, and it was provided with a trough of grass, a hay, a bundle of dry grass, and it was made to settle down. The bed was made over it for the little baby cub to settle there, and an old blanket was also given to that baby cub to curl around. Okay, and as soon as the baby was alone, it started missing its mother and it started giving a cry, a sad cry. But the children could not hear it, because the children, once they settled the cub, they had also went upstairs because they couldn't have taken the child, sorry, they couldn't have taken the cub along with them. So they had to leave it there only, and they went upstairs to their room, and they also, after this tiresome journey, had cuddled around and went to fast asleep. The great moon rose white and solemn above the hills and poured her silver over the forest, and the whole world seemed asleep too. Now gradually, as the night descended, the moonlit night it was, and it was the silver, the moon gives out a silver light, right? It's a bright light. The white light has been compared to the silver light of the moon. So gradually it was a moonlit night, and as the night approached, everyone fell fast asleep, and only it was the moonlight which had covered not only the forest but the whole area around. So we stop here for now.